Hello, my loves. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you for viewing in. Before we start this video, I need to add this disclaimer. This video may contain very, very strong information that may be deemed controversial, inappropriate, or too strong for sensitive viewers. So if you are at all extremely sensitive to strong information, what I deem to be the truth, please, please, I advise viewer discretion. Once again, this video may contain strong information that may be sensitive to some viewers, so viewer discretion is very much advised. Okay guys, now we can get down right to it. This video is a wake-up video. This video is going to incorporate a lot of the information that you have probably heard before, some new information. Those of you who follow me and know my paranormal or not videos 1 through 5, if you watched those videos, you follow me because you like my stories. This is a culmination, a continuation, a kind of a conglomeration of all the information that I continue to pick up on. I'm still in the process of reading. I just finished a book by David Icke called Children of the Matrix, which I definitely recommend that you read one of his books, please, to better understand everything that I'm about to tell you. I'm only touching on these topics. None of what I'm saying is enough. Like I said, it's an ocean of information, and I'm just skimming a little quadrant of the surface. So if you really want to dive deep and you want to know more, you definitely have to read, do your own research. And even if you're just picking up on keywords, like most of the presidents of the United States are related, if that in any way upsets you, like it upset me when I first heard this statement, and that's when I dove in, and the rest is history. So without further delay, please like, comment, subscribe. Please interact with me. Tell me what you think about my videos. And if you have any comments at all, good or bad, please leave them below. I will be more than happy to reply or comment back. So let us begin. This video is going to be tagged Wake Up. This is my message. We all as human beings need to wake up. And before I begin, I just want you to know, this information comes from books I've read, from things I remember from when I was a teenager so long ago that have like come back to me now, and I'm incorporating into the new information I'm finding, and everything kind of has come together for me. So yes, I am listening to whistleblowers. David Icke is considered to be like a conspiracy theorist, and he's not taken seriously, but you know what? He is the one and only, not, I shouldn't say one and only, but he is one of the people that is trying to spread the truth. And even though he has spread it to many, many people, he needs a lot of help. We need a lot of help in waking the hell up, because this information, nobody knows. Unless you follow someone who is supposedly a conspiracy theorist, or who is deemed in the public light as crazy, a liar, you're not going to know any of this information. And I'm not a liar. I'm not crazy. I know who I am now. I know what my body is physically capable of. And that's where you have to start. Do you know what your body is really capable of? Do you remember that we are energy? We are consciousness first before we are this flesh. So all of that, you have to really, really know all of this before you can look at this information with a neutral perspective and just take it all in. So before I continue, because I can go on and on and on, I don't want this video to be too long, let me start. Okay, there's proof all over the planet that the human race has been manipulated in every way over centuries. And just in case, I am going to be reading a little bit, mostly talking, but reading a bit, because this is just too much for me to remember in detail. Okay, there are the stones of Baalbek, the Nazca lines of Peru, the pyramids of Giza. We as a human race have been spiritually, physically, and geographically heavily influenced. There are many legends and stories all over the world that speak of a time of a golden age which was eradicated by the fall of man. Hence the Bull.org story, the Adam and Eve story in the Bible. Why do I say that's bullshit? Because that is some ridiculous story of what human beings actually did to come to where we are right now. And I'm going to tell you, I'm going to just be blunt, and I'm going to tell you the truth. And again, you have to take this with a grain of salt because this is my perspective, and I am rewording it to fit me so that I can better explain it to you. Do I know 100% the truth of everything? No, of course not. I wasn't there, and there is no I'm not going to have a video or paperwork. You kind of have to use your common sense and know that this information is coming from a real source. But anyway, the Adam and Eve story. Do you really believe that a snake slithered into a garden and tempted a woman with an apple, and then all of humanity all of a sudden fell from grace? Really? Do you really believe that? What happened was, we have always had an alien presence on the planet. That alien presence and just a mix of every other thing I can't get into. My main point is that we as a human race agreed to interbreed with this reptilian being. That was it. That was our fall. Does this reptilian being a fallen angel? Is it just a being that broke away from that pure, beautiful consciousness that created all the consciousness ever known in the universe? I can't say that for sure, but I know that that was the agreement we made. And it gets worse. So let me just continue. Now, if you want to know more about this golden age, I would advise you to read the Book of Enoch. During the time of the Book of Enoch, which that part was so conveniently taken out of the Bible, during that time period, we were living to 365 years of age, believe it or not. And the world, the earth, was in a much better space. We were living much better lives. We're much more spiritual. We were who we were meant to be at that time. But once the cataclysm hit, this was another huge impact that just brought us even further down. We had already made the deal to interbreed with these reptilians, and once we made that deal, just all hell breaks loose. That's where the Nephilim come in. Nephilim are real. And the Nephilim are the offspring between these fallen beings, aka the fallen angels, and human beings. So we were interbreeding with different beings on a mass scale. And at one point, if this was out in the open, we worshiped them, mostly reptile. You cannot deny there's reptile symbolism in every religion around the world. You can't deny that. You cannot deny that. And this is what brought us down further. But you will know this cataclysm is depicted in the Bible as a Noah's Ark story. At that time, we fell even lower. When that cataclysm hit the planet and everything became an entire mess, everything was destroyed. What happened was, we as human beings, boom, that's why we only live to 45 to 80 years old now. Because of, first of all the intermingling of human beings and these other beings that we were never meant to breed with. This is what created the human beings with the Rh negative, Rh positive blood, which I will explain to you in 1 second. But it changed our DNA. It changed our frequency level. So obviously the higher frequencies, the highest of all frequencies, is where I believe heaven is. The lower fourth is where most demons are, most all the negative evil spirits go to, and we are the third dimension. So what happened was, we fell from whatever high frequency we were at that time during the time when Enoch lived, when the cataclysm hit, which is the Noah's Ark story. We fell from that frequency right slam bam next to the lower fourth dimension. So let me continue a little. Let me change the subject a little bit. I'm going to be going back and forth, but definitely remember that. This proof of how we are connected to otherworldly beings are in the clay tablets, which are numbered in the tens of thousands, and they were found in 1850 in Iraq by Sir Austin Henry Layard. That sources back to Sumeria, which existed 4000 to 2000 BC. These tablets are known to be written by the Anunnaki. Now, believe it or not, if you don't believe anything that I'm saying, if you look up these clay tablets, they are real. They exist. And when they were doing the translations, again, if you don't believe, they were able to match up the constellations of the stars at that time from what they wrote in the clay tablets. So, kind of hard to deny. It's just kind of hard to deny, period, when you have that type of proof. And also, most of the religions around the world are highlighted in these tablets. So, if nothing else makes you believe, you should definitely research and look into that. Okay, so during the story that they were able to translate from the tablets includes how these Anunnaki, how these beings from heaven to earth fell, why they were here, basically to mine gold. They did not want to do it themselves. They got tired. Gold, as you know, is used for many, many, many different things, and it makes electronics run unbelievably well. That's why, well, we don't use it now because our reality is just too negative and everyone would just be breaking everything apart to try to get the gold. But if gold was used in electronics, they would work a million times better than they normally do. But yeah, so they were here to mine the gold. They developed us as slave labor, and they were still fighting amongst themselves for power and control. So, in the beginning, when they did create us in test tubes, because as you know, we can do that now, or Lord knows what we can do now. I'm sure we can do far more than what we were able to do before. But in the creation of us, you know, they created atrocities. They created things like monsters. And you can see in the Egyptian hieroglyphs, if you bother to dive into Egyptian theory or Egyptian storylines, you will see that a lot of these creatures are depicted on the walls, and it's not just symbolism. Then, of course, they got better, and then they decided to mix their own DNA with our DNA, and we are the human beings that we are now because of them. And we were all slaves, and pretty much we still are. We were slave labor, everybody on the planet. At one point, we were not able to have children. And once again, their laziness, they did not want to have to go back into their laboratory, wherever they were concocting the human hybrids that we are. They didn't want to go back into the lab and do that, so they decided to give us make us fertile to have our own children. But when we proliferated in numbers, they decided to pull back and they left the planet eventually, but left a big fat heaping mess behind. Now, you have to also keep in mind there has always been a reptilian presence on the planet. Like I said, before they even came down here to get the gold, there were reptilians within the earth. And they didn't give a rat's ass who was on the planet. They just found the gold. They wanted it. They came down and did what they want. And these reptilians were not too happy about that. There has always been an attraction for otherworldly beings. Again, reptilian and human alike in form attracted to this planet. And one of those, I'm sure you've heard of them, are the Nordics. The ones that with the blonde hair and blue eyes. And the Drax, which come from the Draconian constellation. And the Drax, they're mentioned in the Bible. They're the demons that we depict now. It's very confusing. I hope you can follow. But these are the Drax. And the third are from the lower fourth dimension. Those beings that were thrown to the earth in the time of the wars, where they're saying between angels and God. And they're trapped within in the lower fourth dimension. They are the worst of the worst. Now, I've already told you about how we slid down and now we're right next to the lower fourth dimension because we are the third dimension. You already know that the Adam and Eve story, what it really was, our allowance of interbreeding with these beings. And I've already told you about the RH negative and RH positive beings that were created from this union. Now, in the 40s and 50s, there was a lot of nuclear testing. This is where the Roswell incident comes in. Which is right about that time. But when they started doing this nuclear bombing, it opened a portal in the time-space fabric, and a lot of these entities, just whether they were from the fourth dimension, I don't know what dimension, they could be from other dimensions, poured through, and that's when shit really got real. And that's when things, the control of humanity really, really, really took a very, very, very strong hold, because it wasn't ever as strong as it was during that time when that hole in the earth was created because of all the nuclear testing. Remember, in that war between good and bad, those beings were thrown to the earth. They were thrown to the earth, meaning an earthly frequency close to our own. And when that portal opened up, they all came through. Wish I could elaborate on that, but I don't know a whole lot more of information except that. Now, again, keep in mind there are 13 families in control of the planet. Some are royalty, basically all royalty around the world, top clearance government officials, their family members, celebrities in every aspect of celebritydom. So music, acting, whatever it is that you're famous for. Many, if not most, of these people are related, hence the presidents, or practically most of the presidents being related. They have gone under trauma-based mind control, and some are handlers and some are slaves to their handlers. Some names you may recognize: Rockefellers, Vanderbilts, Rothschilds. Those are all very old names, but the list continues, and I have so many more names, but I want this video to get posted. I don't want it to be flagged in any way. This particular platform is very, very sensitive to things that I might say that might take the video off the platform. So I'm not going to go too into detail on that. But the list definitely goes on, on and on. And the way that they are part of the way, a big part of the way that they are getting their control on us, one, of course, by interbreeding with us, and they've been doing that for hundreds and thousands of years. So this is nothing new. I can say it nonchalantly because it's nothing new. And if you're not, you gotta look up trauma-based mind control, because I can't get into that. That is just too, it's too vile and it's too extreme, and I can't. But if you want to look that up, please do look up MK Ultra and Project Monarch, and you will see. You will see how some humans are being controlled. Some humans can be turned on with a word and sent out to do whatever atrocity that they want done. And the public will not know, will just not know, will think it's a tragedy, will celebrate the dates. We're so blinded by what's really going on that we won't see the truth of what's really happened. And that's what I'm trying to kind of get you privy to. Now, the children from these lines are given away, or sometimes they are given, not given away, but there are structured adoptions to specific people who are in the know. So most of the people, like these celebrities, the royalty, especially the royalty around the world, and the powers that be, these people are, they're the ones, these top people, which there aren't that many, there's very few of them, but these top people are the ones in the know. They know that by sticking to their line, which is marrying cousins and marrying other people with the same blood type, Rh positive, Rh negative, by sticking to those, to that structure and that family lineage, they can now take these children that they are giving away in a structured adoption, so that they grow up under different names and they can be pushed right back into control. So they're not really losing their grip and their hold on the power that they have to control the few controlling the many. And how you must have questions about how are they controlling? Why is it important for them to stay within family members and keep the same bloodline going? Because Rh negative and Rh positive people are better suited to interbreed with these beings. Get it now? Okay, so once the children are adults, like I said, these are the people who you see as our presidents, congressmen, rulers all over the world with vast power. And I'm sorry, I'm kind of not speaking as clearly as I can because I'm trying to really get all this information out. Okay, so as you know, whoever controls food, power, weapons, air, water, they pretty much control the world. These families in power control transportation, interest rates, imports, exports, laws, religion. In other words, anything human beings need to survive, they decide what we can and cannot have, and that is very true. They control freedoms, price of food, education, health, weather, still think you're free. We are so not free. And there's a lot of stuff that is happening right now that's leading us to one world government. And if you think that 5G is great and all of this tech-based where you can pay for everything on this little thing, you think all that's great. Once cash is gone, they have us. They will have us in ways that you couldn't even possibly imagine. Because if you dare to do anything wrong, defy, not pay a tax or follow a rule, guess what? There's no cash for you to rely on. So with one button, they can completely destroy you. And they're also, people are already being chipped. So this is all an agenda towards one world government, one army, and one monetary unit, which will be anything electronic, which is online, connected to the web. So, yeah. So much for freedom. Okay. So, David Icke could not have said it better. We are the children of the Matrix, hence his book. And again, I also wanted to mention a lot of my information did come from my research I did on my own. So it's not only from David Icke's books, or there's another lady that you definitely should look into. Her name is Linda Moulton Howe. I was following her as a teenager. She didn't know the information she knows now, so I got back into her. And if you go on YouTube, she has a channel just like David Icke. If you don't want to read, you don't have to read. You can just listen to some of their videos and immediately get caught up on what the hell is really happening out there. Now, over thousands of years, religion has been the best served structure for human control, and it was not written in the way it was meant to be read, it followed. So basically what I'm trying to say is that I'm not saying that, God, how can I say this? I'm not pointing a finger. I'm not saying that what you believe in is incorrect. I'm telling you it's been modified by human hands. And it's unfortunate that they leave a lot of truth and a lot of goodness in those texts, but at the same time, they have changed it. Hello, the King James Bible. Look up what happened with King James and that Bible, and then tell me that whatever text you're reading from is 100%. It isn't. And that's when your discernment comes into play. That's when your gut comes into play. Okay, so my lovely camera cut me off. I promise this won't be too much longer because the video is pretty long. Back to religion, the Illuminati. I'm going to repeat because I'm not sure really where this left off, but the Illuminati are the biggest group of people who have vast power, and they have a major strategy. They have a major strategy installed into their religions. First, you create the original belief, which, depending on who or what the attention is on, triggers divisions and conflicts with other religions. Then, the original belief is shattered into an ever-expanding list of sub-beliefs and offshoot churches. Now you have division between the beliefs and the belief itself. Perfect way to divide and conquer. Once you have everyone fighting and condemning each other, their job becomes even easier. And my point that I'm trying to get to with this is that all of our religions have been tampered with. And ever wonder why there's so many different religions? Why one religion is so strict, another is a little more open, one is pointing fingers, and the other one will kill anybody for not believing a certain thing or not doing a certain thing. I mean, it's utterly ridiculous when there is one beautiful, conscious light. One being that is bigger than anybody on this planet that has created our consciousness. There is a being, a person, whatever you want to call him. For me, it's Jesus. For you, it could be another name. But they're the ones who created our consciousness. Why are we all fighting over things that we don't know? We're not actually sure who wrote it. And we're not actually sure who changed the information along the way. So that is my point. I'm not pointing any fingers at any particular religion about being right or wrong. I'm just saying that if your gut is telling you something is wrong, that you're following something that makes you uncomfortable, that things are happening that shouldn't be happening when they're supposed to be creating an environment of love, support, prayer, and everything else that they deem to be good, but you're uncomfortable with it, you have every right to find out how, why, when, where all of this was created and why, and question why you're following certain things. The only thing that really is important that you to be spiritual is to believe that there is something bigger than you out there, that this is not an eternal existence, this is not the only existence, that something beyond this life is waiting for us, and that we are immortal. We are immortal. The flesh isn't immortal, but our consciousness is. And that's what they should be teaching us, not these ridiculous separations and studying of all these different things that they're making us do because they say. And it's unfortunate that a lot of the base information, which is meant to guide us, to help us spiritually and be the best human beings we can be, has been altered and has been modified to human, to satisfy a human need, to satisfy. Look at the King James Bible. If you don't believe me or you're in not in agreement with this, please look up the King James Bible and how that Bible came to be, and then tell me that I'm completely wrong. But anyway, the Illuminati are also behind mind control, and it is very, very real. Now, the book I'm about to mention is The Transformation of America. This is the story of Kathy O'Brien and Mark Phillips. This is a true life story of a human being that was a mind control slave. If you are not strong enough, this is just another forewarning. You really need to be strong of mind, of heart, of spirit, of constitution to be able to get through this book. And I mean that in the most serious way. I know I'm telling you to read it, but I don't want you to come back and be completely discombobulated or scarred for eternity because you read this book. I'm letting you know that if you want to know what mind control does, how it's incorporated into or how it's inflicted upon specific humans by the powers that be, you need to read this book and it'll open your eyes to things that you never even knew before. But please make sure that you're in the right space, you're right in the right headspace, emotionally, spiritually, physically, to be able to deal with the content in the book because it is very strong and could be mind altering if you're not strong enough to read it. So just be aware. Now, no one is spared with this mind control, and it, like I said, there's very few people who are undergoing it compared to the population of the planet, but no one is spared, especially political figures. It's in sports. Everything is it's everywhere. It's everywhere. If you're a celebrity, if you're a singer, if you're one of the sons or the daughters of these powers, that the families of the powers that be that are very close to the main people who are in control of everything on the planet, you are susceptible to it, especially if there has been any type of horrible abuse, sexually, emotionally, physically going on in these families. That's they if they know that you have undergone any type of abuse in that way, aka the primary example is Marilyn Monroe. She had it in her family consecutively, and from what I hear, she was also under severe mind control. Her title was the perfect presidential model. And if you read her story, you know anything about her, I think you know what I'm talking about when I say presidential. But anyway, let me go a little bit further, and actually not further, but elaborate. I didn't know sports was involved. So sports is involved, and I didn't know that some players could be mind controlled, and they are. This was a total shock to me. This information I read in the Transformation of America book. As you know, the powers that be, these people who have vast amounts of money and power around the world, they're tied to drugs. They're tied to our very Ponzi scheme banking system. Money's being laundered. Drugs are exchanging hands. And the point I'm trying to make back to baseball is that when certain owners of these teams obviously are very wealthy and very powerful, when they want different things to exchange hands, whether it's power, favors, drugs, whatever the case may be, they rig the games, they trigger their mind-controlled players, and boom, a team wins that shouldn't otherwise have won. And I think if you're a fan of sports, you will know, and I'm pretty sure it's not just allocated to baseball. I'm pretty sure other sports are also involved in it too. But in the end, to sum all this up, in the end, this is where everything is going. Obviously, you know now that it's going to a one world government. They want one official group, one very small group governing the world and everything involved with people that are in it. They want one monetary unit, meaning everything done through devices and through online access. So they want no more cash, and they want one world army that they can, you know, call at the drop of a hat anywhere around the world. That is the main agenda. But also behind this main agenda, in order to have that full control, this includes breeding hybrids using human and alien genetic material and replacing human society with these hybrids under their control. Hence all of that. It would be a hierarchy and a fascist order in which ruling caste dominates lesser caste. This is what they're up to. This is what they want. This is the agenda. So I wanted to do this video so you can wake up, so I can help one person wake up, so that if any of this information pops out to you, whether you look up Linda Moulton Howe, you read a David Icke book, you look into mind control, the MK Ultra or Project Monarch, or you look into the reasons why most of our presidents are related, I'm gonna drop the mic. But I'm gonna leave you with this, because this video has been really, really long. Guys, make good reading decisions, because that's very important in informing yourself and staying on top of the situation. Please help yourself wake up, get informed, and I will definitely see you in my next video. Bye.